So I was trying to come up with a really super simple example of the max creation graph and what you could do to get something visible on the screen with the fewest number of nodes. And what I came up with was, why don't we just go ahead and color some vertices on this object? So I've got my object there. I've created this modifier called blue vert color, and that's all it does. Makes all the vertices blue, has no parameters, nothing more to it, really simple graph, but it gives you an idea of something that you can do without too much fuss. So let's take a look at how we would do that. So we know that this guy is going to be a modifier. To make a modifier, we have to create an output modifier, and we know that we're going to be grabbing some mesh data. You know, we're working on a mesh, and so we need a modifier trimesh. Okay, and somewhere in between here, we're going to be coloring some vertices. Fortunately, there's a compound already in place called color vertices, and this does most of the heavy lifting for us. We can begin to hook this guy up a little bit. So we know that we're working on this mesh, and we know that we're going to be dumping it out to a modifier. Now we got to do something with it. So what is it that we're going to do? We're going to put a color into all of these vertices, and it just happens that, you know, a color is really just a vector three. It's three floats worth of information, R, G, and V, but somebody's seen fit to go ahead and be kind enough and give us a compound that just happens to be blue. But under the hood, if we were to look at this guy, they've kind of done the heavy lifting for us. They've given us three values, and they've got it in just one of the channels, and that's what's going to give it make it blue for us. So when you're looking at it, it really seems like you ought to just be able to hook these guys up. The interesting thing is, if you run this, you're going to get an error, and the reason being is, if we look at this color vertices compound, and down here at the signature, it's expecting a trimesh as an input. We've got that. And then it's looking at a function that it's going to do for every single vertice, and it's got two vector threes. Well, we really only have the color that we're putting in there, and so if we were to run it, it's going to complain that it's missing an argument. So that's not going to work for us. What we need to do, and this is just a little bit of a trick, is we're going to tell it to ignore one of the arguments. And we're going to use just the second one. And if we look at this ignore first, it tells you exactly that. And that way it's going to satisfy the needs of this color vertices compound without actually giving it anything. It's just kind of stubbed out. So let's go ahead and save this guy. And we'll call it just a test version of this blue vert color. Let's evaluate that, and now we can get rid of the version that we had on there. We'll go into our modifier stack. Here it is. Okay, so that's about as simple as it gets. We haven't really done too terribly much, certainly no parameters in here, but we've taken one set of data and slammed it into all the vertices colors, and bam, there it is. If we wanted to get a little bit fancier with this, we certainly could. Instead of having this static color, go ahead and get rid of that, we could say, let's put in a vector 3, which of course that blue was a vector 3, it was just forcing it into only information in the blue channel. And then each one of these singles, let's do it as a parameter so we can actually see it in the modifier panel. So if we pull up a parameter single, we could treat each one of these as one of the color channels. So let's just call that red. And we'll drag down another one for blue. Let's shift over another one for green. By default, the max value is 100. We really only want each one of these to go to 1. Otherwise, it's not going to make sense because we're going to do 0 to 1. And let's just give it default 0.5 for each one of these. So we've got something other than just black when the thing starts. And then wire each one of these guys up. And notice, when it evaluates, all of a sudden, instead of being blue, our teapot is now gray. And if we were to change any one of these new parameters, we can see that we can set it anywhere 0 to 1 and get the corresponding color that we're expecting. So, again, it's a really pretty simple graph in what we're doing, but it gives you some kind of idea also that you can open up somebody else's graph as long as you can get in there and begin to understand a little bit about what they're doing. It's pretty easy to start tinkering around with it, and we've gone from something that was just a fixed color to giving it some parameterization and exposing those parameters in the UI, and you can start playing with it from there. Talk to you next time.